Hello, my name is Richard Harmon. I lead our financial services vertical globally. Thank you for joining us to discuss the exciting role of AI in transforming the insurance industry. From enhancing underwriting to improving customer experiences, AI is helping insurers operate more efficiently. Let's dive into some key topics. With me, I have two great speakers. Could you please introduce yourselves?
Sure. Thank you, Richard. So my name is Monique Hesseling, and within the financial services team, I oversee our efforts around the insurance industry. And I do want to point out, it's not often that I get introduced with the word exciting and insurance in one sentence, Richard. So thank you for that.
And my name is Hector Arias, and I am the retail banking global lead. I'm based in Madrid, Spain. So very happy to be here.
Right. Wonderful. Okay, let's start with Monique. How are insurance companies using AI today?
That's a good question. And the short answer would be everywhere, all over the place. Because think about it, what do insurers actually do? Insurers do not manufacture anything. They get data and information in. They take a decision based on that, and then they execute on that decision. So it's either to underwrite or price a new customer, whatever way or form, or to decide what needs to happen to a claims request. So it's a very process, data-driven environment. That's what insurers do. So if you think about it at any one of those points, there is a lot to gain by AI, right, or machine learning in that space. So insurers have been playing around or working around AI and its applications for a long time now. More recently, over the last year or so, generative AI is obviously the buzzword. So if you look specifically what they're doing in that space, there are three or four big drivers of activities there. The first one is individualized marketing and sales, really try to get people the offers that are most relevant for them and appropriate in their hands. So that's step one. Step two is automation of IT and other processes. That's a really big area where they're looking at generative AI to help. Step three is document analytics and summarizations. Insurance are very paper-heavy organizations, as you know. And the last one is chatbots and that type of support. And they start doing that internally. So they do knowledge-based driven chatbotting for their employees. And some of them now are getting ready to actually do a good job on doing it externally too, to help customers figure out what's covered, what to do in case of a claims, those types of initiatives. So there's a lot going on in and around AI and insurance.
Great. Fantastic. Hector, with the rapid adoption of AI, governance and ethical considerations are increasingly important. How can insurance companies use governance and control models to ensure that AI is ethically, fairly, and in compliance with regulations?
Well, indeed, both predictive and generative AI bring risk and not only the advantages, right? Something that control framework overall, or governance should take care of. So generally speaking, AI models are fed with data, right? So, and data has been built for to build those models are so important for that. So some of the ingredients that these control frameworks might include could be like first and foremost choosing a model or the models, not only one, but the models that the insurance organization will need that are not black boxes, right? So something that you know the data that was used for training that model. That is very important and can be one of the ingredients. The second one could be using guardrails for the input and output of those models. That this is mainly but not restricted to Gen AI. So models shouldn't try to answer all the questions. And for instance, regulation prohibits some product recommendations that those guardrails can prevent this to happen, right, to in interaction with the model. And some outcomes or answers should be double-checked, sometimes even for a human, until the model is mature enough to be to run along. And the third one ingredient, the third ingredient could be like something pretty basic, but it's something very important when something new comes in, right? It's picking your battle, something that choose a few use cases that might increase your organization understanding and increase the experience gradually, not try to disrupt the industry from minute zero, right? So this might be three of the ingredients that could be included in a control framework to prevent or to reduce, to mitigate some risk of the risk that AI is bringing to the industry. Yeah.
Thank you, Hector. Those for the wonderful insights. Let's move to the last question with Monique. Looking ahead, what key changes and trends do you anticipate impacting insurance companies next year, and especially with regard to AI advancements and regulatory shifts?
Yeah, again, a really good question. And Hector mentioned a couple of those things, so I will elaborate a little bit on that. The NAIC, the National Association of Insurance Commissioners, in the United States, which is actually a very international organization. They're actually regulators from the whole world, not only in the United States, recently did a study on their insurers with pretty much exactly the question that you just asked. And what was surprising to me was that about 25% of the respondents, which was leadership in insurance companies, were holding off a little bit on rolling out generative AI, Gen AI type of initiatives. And their key reason was that they had a hard time finding the right use case. Like, if we want to start somewhere, we are a little bit concerned that we're not picking the right one. And I think we can help there. The second reason was, and that goes back to what Hector said earlier, about 10, 15% of them said we're just waiting for more regulations to come out to get clarity on regulations. Because, as you know, insurance is regulated at many different levels. There's a lot of regulations that insurance companies have to deal with, and they feel that the whole AI and generative AI area is not solidified enough yet from a regulatory perspective for them to invest heavily on. So those are like the two core findings there. Where they are looking at primarily is on underwriting, pricing, marketing, claims, the core functions of insurance. And a really big thing that they're focusing on next year is removing any kind of potential bias and removing any kind of unexplained black box decision. So a lot of the efforts are around, you know, event-driven decisioning or fact-driven decisioning or data-driven decisioning, find your favorite words. So that's what we start seeing right now is a big area of focus for insurers globally.
Excellent. Thank you. Thank you, Hector and Monique. You've convinced me that insurance is an exciting area, especially with what AI is doing to the industry and the challenges. So thank you for sharing your insights and appreciate you joining this event.
Thank you, Richard.